Welcome again. Our next topic on digital design course is the analysis and design of sequential circuits. First, we start with the analysis procedure of sequential circuits. In the analysis procedure, the input is the circuit diagram, and we need to find out the characteristic table, the state diagram, and the description of the circuit if possible. The analysis of sequential circuits is usually performed using the following three steps. First, we should find out the flip-flop inputs and the circuit outputs. Next, derive the characteristic and the state tables. And finally, derive the state diagram and, if possible, the description of the circuit. Before moving on, I should note that there are two types of sequential circuits, milli and more. In milli sequential circuits, the output values are determined both by the current state and the current inputs, while in more sequential circuits, the output values are determined by the current state. Here we have the state diagram of a sequential circuit of type milli. The circuit has one input X, one output Y, and two flip-flops. We name them A and B, and they are of type D. First, we have to find out the input values of the D flip-flop. DA equals X or QB. QB equals not X and with QB. Here, the values. And the value of Y equals QA or not X and it with not QB. Now we can use these equations to find out the characteristic table of this circuit. Since we have two flip-flops and one input X, then in the characteristic table we have eight states, here they are, and we have to find the next state for the A flip-flop and the B flip-flop and the output Y. Here you have to remember that the next state for the D flip-flop equals to input D. So the next state of the A flip-flop equals to DA. Here we have DA. It's X or QB. Here 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. The next state for the D flip-flop equals to DB, which is not X and with the QB. Here we have 0, here 0, here we have 1, here not X, 0, and here 0, not X, 0, here not X, 1, and here 0. The output Y equals to QA or with not X, not B. QA is 1 here, and not X, not Q of B equals 1 here, and in all the other states, zeros. So this is the characteristic table for the given circuit. From the characteristic table, we can derive the state diagram. We have four states. We assign 0, 0 to the first state, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. If the current state is 0, 0 and the input X is 0, then the next state is 0, 0 and the output Y is 1. Here 0, 0, the next state is 0, 0 if X is 0 and the output is 1. If the current state is 0, 0 and the input is 1, then the next state is 1, 0 and the output is 0. Next, if the current state is 0, 1 and the input X is 0, then the next state is 1, 1 and the output is 0. On 0, 1, if the input X is 1, then the next state is 1, 0 and the output is 0. Here is the case. Now in 1, 0, if the input is 0, the next state is 0, 0 and the output is 1. Again, on 1, 0, if the input X is 1, then the next state is 1, 0 and the output is 1. Here is the case. And finally, on 1, 1, if the input X is 0, then the next state is 1, 1 and the output is 1. And on 1, 1, if the input x is 1, then the next state is 1, 0, and the output is 1. So this is the state diagram for the given circuit. From this state diagram, we can perform reductions if possible and redesign the circuit using another flip-flop. Here we have another example. Again, the circuit has 1 input X, 1 output Y, 2 flip-flops of type JK. We name them A and B. The flip-flop inputs are JA equals to X, KA equals not X, not Q of B, as you see here, JB equals not QA, and KB equals X. The output Y equals to X or QA, exclusive or QB. From these equations, we can derive the characteristic and the state tables for the circuit. And from the characteristic table, we can derive the state diagram. Since we have 2 flip-flops and 1 input X, then we'll have 8 states in the characteristic table. We have to find the flip-flop inputs and the next states for the flip-flops and the output Y. First, GA equals X, so it is 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. KA equals not X, not QB, so it is here 1 and here 1. And on the remaining states, it is 0. JB equals not QA, here 4 ones and here 4 zeros. KB equals X, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Now to find the next state for the flip-flop A, you can use the characteristic equation for the JK flip-flop or use these inputs if you remember how JK flip-flop functions. On JK 0, 1, we have the reset state. On 1, 0, we have the set state. On 0, 0, we have store. QA was 0, so the next state will be 0. On 1, 0, we have set. 0, 1, reset, 1, 0, again set, 0, 0, store. QA was 1, so the next state will be 1, and on 1, 0, set. Next, to find the next state for the B flip-flop, we have to use the inputs JB and KB. On 1, 0, we have set, 1, 1, store complement, and QB was 0, so the next state will be 1. On 1, 0, set, on 1, 1, store complement, it was 1, the next state will be 0. On 0, 0, store, it was 0. Here we have 0. On 0, 1, reset. On 0, 0, store, it was 1, so we'll have here 1. And on 0, 1, reset. The output Y equals X, QA, exclusive or QB. So here we have 0. Here again, 0 exclusive or 0, 0. Here we have 1 exclusive or 0, 1. And here we have 0 exclusive or 1, 1. Here XA 0 exclusive or 0, 0. Here XA 1 exclusive or 0, 1. Here XA 0 exclusive or 1, 1. And finally, XA here 1 and QB 1. So the exclusive OR is 0. Here is the output Y. Now we have the characteristic table for the given circuit. From this table, we can derive the state diagram. We have 4 states. We assign them the values 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. Now if the state is 0, 0, and the input X is 0, then the next state is 0, 1, and the output is 0. If the state is 0, 0, and the input X is 1, then the next state is 1, 1, and the output is 0. Next, on 0, 1, if the input X is 0, then the next state is 0, 1, and the output is 1. Here. if the state is 0, 1 and the input is 1, then the next state is 1, 0 and the output is 1. Next, on 1, 0, if x is 0, then the next state is 0, 0 and the output is 0. On 1, 0, if the input is 1, then the next state is 0, 0 again. But here the output is 1. And finally, if the state is 1, 1 and the input x is 0, then the next state is 1, 1 and the output is 1. Here we have it. And if the state is 1, 1 and the input is 1, then the next state is 1, 0 and the output is 0. This is the state diagram for the given circuit. For now, thank you.